Man, it's been a long time. Here we have a Gateway HD monitor from 2005. But it was made by Samsung. And the reason why it doesn't have a LCD screen itself is because, well, you guessed it, it's broken. What's broken? The power supply. Let's take a look. So, apparently, this power supply was actually refurbished, well before I got it. Apparent because these seven blue capacitors have been replaced very poorly. Try and get as much light onto it as possible, and I have to zoom, start moving in very slowly, otherwise it's not going to focus properly. But you can see, you may not be able to see it very well on camera, but there's kind of this solder residue, and there's even some, looks like apparent knife marks, in where all seven of those capacitors have been replaced. Now the reason why it doesn't look so bad is because, well, I re-refurbished this section. Now this section here actually drives the, I gotta slowly back it out, otherwise it's not gonna focus. And it's a fairly new camera, so I don't know why it's having trouble. Okay. So basically what was happening was, well, let's go over it quickly. Here's the main input. Which two filter capacitors, by the way, are missing because, well, they went bad. This here is the LCD power supply, and right here is the ballast for the LCD backlight, because it's a fluorescent backlight. This is before LEDs really took off in backlights. So these seven capacitors here that are blue have already been replaced. This green one here is still original. And I still need to get a couple of new filter capacitors for it. Here's one right here. Now will it... Yeah, there we go. Perfect. Yeah, I don't know that company, Samsung. Sounds like some cheap generic brand. This one was still okay, but the other one was, it, which is identical to this one, actually bulged on the top. So that was clearly gone. This one didn't, so I'm assuming it may be okay. I could be wrong. Unfortunately, my capacitance meter is not working right now. It's been broken for a while. I don't know why. It keeps reading zero. When I know it's not there, I don't know if it's a bad solder joint. Which, by the way, here's a shout out. If anyone knows what the problem could be, it's a UNI-T, UT-603. And unfortunately, now the, first off, the resistance and continuity checking works fine. I'm sure even the HFE for the transistors, they also work fine. Unfortunately, when I test the inductance and capacitance, it just keeps zeroing out on the scale. And yes, I know you have to switch this mode from L to C if you're doing capacitance, and from C to L when you're doing inductance. I know that, so don't tell me that, because it's still doing that. I even tried to re-solder some components that may have gotten loose over time, but it still didn't help. So I'm not sure what it is. I'm gonna have to get this thing fixed one way or another. And also, yeah, the fuse, I know it says fused here. I checked the fuse, it's still good. So, not sure what's wrong with that meter, but it just keeps zeroing out every time you test an inductor or a capacitor. But back to the power supply. One thing I noticed, the first thing I noticed when I took it apart was these apparent burn marks in the board. Clearly, the original capacitors were mounted too close to the board and they just started to bulge. They were actually the worst. They looked like they were about to vent. So I just replaced them with two, and they're slightly higher voltage capacitors at 63 volts. The original ones are 25, so these ones will do a lot better. And as you can see, because of all this wasted space here, what I did was I moved the capacitors up a little bit and just bent them off board. Which should be okay, because it's getting them off the board, but at the same time, it's also, well, I know that the heat rises, but it's actually going to rise either this way or that way, because this thing is mounted on a side like this. It's not mounted flat. So, hopefully it'll work. I'm sure it will. But one thing I don't like about the existing refurbishment, of course, not only were the capacitors botched in, but also they're 85 degrees Celsius rated, whereas all the other ones are 105, which is what you want. And on top of that, you also want low ESR, because I believe this type of power supply is... I don't know if this one's actually switch mode, because it's got a lot of transformers, so this one could be linear. Again, I could be wrong, but it almost looks linear. But it still needs new filter capacitors, and, well, this is what I have to replace. I'm going to probably replace them with 100 microfarad if I can. I could probably go down in voltage a little bit to maybe 400 volts, despite this one being 450. But if they're roughly the same size, just a little bit taller, like this way, if they're a little, like, stick out that much longer for 100 microfarad and are no wider, I could probably get away with using the 450 volt versions. But we're gonna see what happens once I get the parts in. Alright. Until then. $16 worth of parts, and a couple days later, and I'm happy to report that the LCD monitor is now working once again. So, a couple of things I wanted to go over. Those Samson capacitors, they were 68 microfarad. When I went to my electronics store, I went to go and get some 100 micro, but they only had one, and I needed two. But they did have two 120 microfarad at 450 volts, and surprisingly, they were no wider. They were actually just a little bit taller, and actually the 68 micros that they had were actually a lot thinner, and they wouldn't have worked. So awesome that it was really awesome that I was able to use a higher value of capacitor, and it's probably better because, well, they're, you know, higher in capacitance, so they're gonna smooth out the ripple voltage a lot nicer, because it is bridge rectified, so the higher the capacitance, the better. And I don't know if I mentioned this in the previous part, but there was this little transient voltage suppressor. It's kind of like a Zener diode. Now, believe it or not, I was able to find a replacement, but it was actually a lot larger than the component, so I actually had to make it, I kind of had to put it surface mount onto the board. It was originally a through-hole component, but I was able to only do it surface mount. It's the way it had to be done. I didn't want to drill out the holes or anything a little larger, because I would have risked damaging the traces on the board. But, I mean, there's nothing really wrong with doing that, as long as it fits. I would have just liked it to have everything on one side of the board. But I've seen worse jobs, believe me. Of course, this monitor was refurbished well before I even had it, so... And I told you how bad it was. I wish I had a photo of how bad it really was before. But now, as you can see, it is now working. If I just... What can I open up here? Let's just do Word. Woo! You know what, I'll turn that part off for you there. There you go. Okay, just took off the task pane. But anyways, there we go. It's all working. The total cost was about $16, including taxes. But then again, what's a brand new 21-inch LCD display? Even though it's a gateway, it's made by Samsung. So, what's a new 21-inch Samsung computer display going to be worth? What, maybe $200? Maybe $300? Yep. If you could save a bit of money, this doesn't get thrown in the landfill. Sorry. Doesn't get thrown in the landfill, and because it's a fluorescent backlight, has less mercury to go in as well. Not so much of a problem now because everything has gone LED backlit. But there you go. It all works.